this model question is related with Montreal protocol. Now the Montreal protocol, it tries to phase out the consumption as well as production of various ozone depleting substances, right? Or in other words, you can say the Montreal protocol is trying to protect the ozone layer, right, by avoiding or by reducing the ozone depletion. Now we know that various ozone depleting substances like chlorofluorocarbons or various such gases, due to the anthropogenic reasons, right, the all of these gases, they are synthetic gases, and these gases can disintegrate the ozone molecules in the ozone layer, which can result in the UV radiations entering the Earth's atmosphere, which can cause cancer and certain other diseases, right? It can result in even climate change, or it can result in the biodiversity loss and such things. So Montreal Protocol is an international protocol which is trying to protect the ozone layer. So this question is regarding, in this context, production and consumption of which of the following ozone depleting substances is not regulated under the Montreal Protocol, right? So this question is regarding the gases which are being regulated, the consumption as well as the production and trading of which various gases are being regulated under the Montreal Protocol, right? So this question is regarding such gases, right? In the options, you can find chlorofluorocarbons, CFCs, hydrochlorofluorocarbons and halons, right? Now before going to the question, let's see the importance of Montreal Protocol. Now in 2017, the year was the 30th anniversary of Montreal Protocol, and in the previous year, UPSC didn't ask a question regarding the Montreal Protocol, and that means this year the topic is very important, right? There are various, this current trend is that, you know, in 2017 there are various questions that were current affair of 2016. Same way in 18 also we'll be having questions coming from the current affair related with 2017. So for that reason, the Montreal Protocol was one of the important topics in 2017's current affair, and which had the 30th anniversary, right? And for that reason, you can expect a question related with the Montreal Protocol coming for your 2018 prelims examination. And another importance, recently the Montreal Protocol was amended in Kigali, right? Kigali, it was amended to phase out the hydrofluorocarbons, right? Remember that gas, the hydrofluorocarbons, right? And if the hydrofluorocarbons, they are greenhouse gases. Now if they are being phased out under the Kigali amendment, you know, it will help us to control the global warming and thereby climate change. And it is been believed that, you know, if you can phase out the hydrofluorocarbons, it will reduce the temperature by as much as 0.5 degrees Celsius by 2100, right, by the end of this century, which makes this phasing out of hydrofluorocarbons a very cost effective method to control the global warming, right? For all of these reasons, right, the anniversary plus the amendment in Kigali and the importance of Montreal Protocol with that of the climate change, right, and all of these reasons, this topic is important, which was in news. Okay, and the gases which are being regulated under the Montreal Protocol, some of those gases are chlorofluorocarbons, halons, carbon tetrachloride, methyl chloroform, methyl bromide, hydrobromofluorocarbons, hydrochlorofluorocarbons, and the bromochloromethane. Right? So it's bit difficult to remember all of these names as such. So you can always think, you know, chlorofluorocarbon, they are obviously under Montreal Protocol, right? I suppose everyone knows this gas, the chlorofluorocarbons. The second term, halon. Halon means, you know, these gases having the halogens in it, say chlorine, bromine and fluorine, these are halogens which are very reactive, which can disintegrate the molecules, the ozone molecules, right? So these are the gases which are being regulated under the Montreal Protocol. Now the question was a not based question, right? Which of these gases are not regulated under the Montreal Protocol? And in the options you can find chlorofluorocarbons, hydrochlorofluorocarbons and halons, right? All of these gases, their consumption as well as production is being regulated under the Montreal Protocol. So here the answer comes out as, which is none, right? The option D.